Ciao from way above the Amalfi Coast. Hi, it's Teresa Tomeo from Tease Italy, and I can't believe we made it all the way up here, and we're not even to the top yet of the Path of the Gods. We are in Praiano, and we are doing finally the Path of the Gods. We're with our wonderful and amazing guide, Monica, who does this how many times a day? At least two times a day.
Yeah.
It's just incredible. A few years ago when we were in Praiano vacationing at our favorite hotel, Tramonto Duro, we were in the pool. It was a hot day like this. We were looking up at this incredible monastery and seeing this up in the hills and the mountains, and we're saying, wow, I wonder what it's like to be up there. And here we are. It is called the Path of the Gods. And Monica, tell us about the name of it and what it was used for hundreds of years ago.
Hey, you got to picture this path like the main connections for people walking and working on the Amalfi Coast. It was the main connection between the mountains and the coast. Okay, so you got to picture this path with people carrying things on their shoulders. Can you believe it?
No.
So potatoes, tomatoes, milk, because there was people working milk and making cheese out of the milk. So they needed to carry it up on top on the village in Agerola, which is very famous. Which is very famous for cheese and many typical products. So that's what we use this path for.
And when did it start to become a tourist attraction? When did people start walking it?
About 20 years ago.
Okay.
We realized how beautiful this was, and it was a pity not to share.
Let's talk about where it starts and where it ends and how you get here and all that good stuff.
Yes, usually we start from Agerola and end up in Nocelle, which we cannot see now because it is above this mountain, but is a high district of Positano, so we end up right above Positano. Agerola as well is 1900 feet above sea level, so today we did a hard work.
It's very hard work. I thought it was in halfway decent shape.
But it's really worth going through this beautiful place, the convent as well.
So, and this convent and St. Dominic's is how old? How old is the building?
So, in 15th century, one part, and there is a very old fresco about the 12th century. Yeah. So, yes.
It's beautiful. Now, unfortunately, the church is closed today, but it's beautiful even from the ground. We'll take some pictures and put it up on the website. We started in Praiano and walked from the town, and you said we went up 1,000 steps?
Yes.
That's why my legs are killing me.
But I get to eat more pasta and pizza later, right?
Oh, yes.
Yeah, yeah.
Now, I would recommend doing it with a guide. It's great because along the way, Monica has been taking the different branches and explaining the organic and all the beautiful different vegetables and the flora and the fauna and all the things that they use and the foods and the olive trees and the pergola. So you get a history lesson. You get a lesson in the plants here and how the people live. But imagine, as she said, walking with things on your back. I mean, we have a backpack and we think that weighs like 100 pounds. But I mean, you need to be in somewhat decent shape. You don't have to be, you know, a triathlete. But make sure before you go, you drink lots of water, bring water with you, wear light clothing. And a day like today is perfect,
it's
right?
Perfect.
With some cloud cover?
Yes.
Yeah. Because I was thinking, we had it scheduled earlier in the week and it was like 100 degrees and pure sun, never would have made it up 10 steps because it's so hot. But thank you so much. You're so informative. This is Monica. How do people find you online if they want to tour with you?
With my email.
Okay, and that is?
I'll give you monicafusco.sentieri@email.com.
Okay, and she's going to give me her name and we'll put it up on the screen for you, and we'll also have it on my website. We'll see you next time, and just pray that I make it all the way up and then all the way down again. See you later. Ciao.